Hello everyone, so welcome to the channel of RD Automation Learning. So today we are going to cover few of the answers related to questions, you know, pertaining to recession. So today in this video we are going to cover the layoffs that you know had happened at Netflix, companies like Google, Microsoft, Meta, Apple, right? Should we join the startups or should we join the MNCs? If you are looking for a change, is this the right time to look for a change? And we will also talk about the hiring freeze. Is the recession time coming up or not, right? So first of all, let us start with these companies one by one. So, you know, Netflix has been, you know, one of the very popular video streaming platform. And as per the news that we have received, you know, it had laid off around 300 employees. And that was also a second round of layoffs, right? So apart from that, the many, you know, many people who are working in the company on a very good creative professional backgrounds, they were having a very creative role in that company. They were also asked to leave the company, and the Netflix has also indicated more future layoffs, right? At the same time, Twitter is there, who has also, you know, recently cut 30% of its recruiting team, right? And has been laying off hundreds of employees. Right. Other tech companies like Nvidia, Snap, Uber, Spotify, Intel, Salesforce, and all the others, they have also slowed down the hiring. So you can say the hiring has freezed almost in these companies. Meta, which was formerly known as Facebook, you know, they have actually, the management has warned employees of serious times ahead, while hiring has also freezed for certain roles. You know, and in Google also, you know, the CEO of the Google, Sundar Pichai, he informed staff about a hiring slowdown this year, right? And there was an internal memo that was given. There was an internal discussion also that happened. And they have also guided, they have also told the employees that they need to be more entrepreneur. And I mean, they need to be more productive. They need to work with more urgency, with more sharper focus, and they have to make sure that they are doing more productive work compared to what they had done earlier. So this time, you know, they are going to review their performance as well. So apart from this, you know, coming to the talk about, you know, Microsoft has also laid off many of the employees, but there is one certain department in Microsoft which is related to Azure department that is having a good hiring. But apart from that, Microsoft has actually laid off many employees, and they have also slowed down their hiring with respect to, you know, in teams like MS Windows, MS Teams, and MS Office departments, right? So this was an update about how, you know, the layoffs has been happening in all these big giant companies like Facebook, Apple, Microsoft, Google, Netflix, what's all happening over there, right? Now, this seems to be a kind of a, you know, concern or kind of a tension with respect to the Indian IT industry. Now, if you are working in some IPOs or, you know, if you are working in some startups, what happened in startups also, more than 11,000 people have been laid off this year. Now, why this thing happened? You know, because see, startups or, you know, these kind of IPOs, they are actually dependent on some external person who are actually providing the funds to run the business. Last year, they got a lot of funds. So a lot of hirings was done. But as soon as they came to know that their departments were running into the losses, that their departments were, you know, not able to come up with those kind of profit margin that a company was expecting, they started, you know, laying off people, and those projects, those work actually got shut down. So actually the layoff took place. So if you are trying to, you know, get into some particular startup, if you are trying to get into some particular, you know, small size company, so before joining this kind of companies, what you have to ensure is you have to see their analysis. You have to see their quarterly reports. What are the statistics of the companies? Did they make some good profit margin? Have they laid off any employees in last 2 years? In last 2 years means in 2022, this year, and in 2021 also. Because in 2021, when COVID was there, when pandemic was there, at that time also a lot of, you know, these things were happening. So we have to ensure before joining any of the companies, just make sure, just be very double sure that these companies have not laid off any employees, right? For example, you can take an example of, you know, you can avoid trying to join, you know, Zomato and Paytm also as of now. because these are the companies. Now, if you take an example of their stock, you know, stock price, so their stock price has also come down, right? But as they are IPO, so they will do anything and everything to push up their stock price. So that's why it can be a possibility that the layoff can happen, right? So these are just an example. You can also avoid trying to join Ola, as well as you know, other companies like Uber. They are also seeing pretty big crisis and have laid off some staff over there as well. Swiggy seems to be doing good as of now, but still we don't have a confirmed news as of now, right? So this was about joining startups, IPOs or MNC companies. Now, when it comes to MNC companies, if you are actually a part of a project which you are going to get from you know, US or UK. Now, again, in MNC company, there is a two things over here. One is if you are working in a product-based company. Second aspect is if you are working in a service-based company, right? In a service-based company, generally the projects are dependent on the you know, client or the customer, and they can be from US or UK, right? So definitely your projects are, your projects might get impacted because of the recession, right? Now, if you are into a product-based company, it might happen that you know, due to this recession, due to this, you know, hiring freeze, layoffs, your project might not get impacted. But again, in product-based companies also, it depends from market to market. For example, Flipkart, Amazon, they are also e-commerce domain-based, but still the layoffs took place, right? So just see in what kind of domain, what kind of department you are working, right? See, generally, an IT industry is such in which, you know, the, there is a demand and there is a work related to the technology, data, softwares. So these things are not at all going to get impacted for the very longer perspective or very longer duration of time, right? In 2008, we saw there were multiple people who were getting laid off from n number of companies, right? Now, our Indian IT industry is somewhat dependent on the US or UK based clients, companies, because they are getting projects from those particular countries, right? So somehow you can see that, you know, the IT industry is dependent on that. But as such, our Indian IT industry has also its own impact as well, right? And you know, you believe me, the organizations, the companies which are contributing to the, you know, which are a part of Indian IT industry, they have done the impact analysis. They are aware, like, you know, of such kind of situations that have happened in the past already, right? There has been times when, you know, many of my subscribers who are telling that we have got multiple offer letters, right? So we cannot say that the recession has started, but yes, hiring has slowed down. There was one of my subscriber who told from, you know, Mike, who actually appeared for a Microsoft, who was going to get interviewed at Microsoft at one of the Redmond office over there. But his on-site interview at Redmond office got canceled, right? And there was an email to him from the recruiter stating that they are re-evaluating the future business needs and apologize for the change, right? So these things are happening. Maybe, you know, you are getting the calls, but your interviews are not getting scheduled. Maybe you have cleared all the interviews, but you're not getting offer letter. Maybe you are getting the offer letter, but you're not getting the date of joining. So these things, you know, what actually means from all these things is that the company in which you are going to join, the company in which you are going to be interviewed, they are actually freezing the hiring for now. They are actually reevaluating the needs, how many employees they have to hire based on the project to project discussion, based on the cost, based on the resources that are already available, or based on the people, those who are already available on the bench with them, right? So accordingly, they will plan and they will do the hiring. So you can also consider the hiring freeze, which has been recently taking place, or you are seeing not many calls are coming. So that is also one of the reasons for this is as well that, you know, many companies have already hired many employees in the last year during the COVID, during the pandemic. And just, you can't imagine at what high percentage they got selected. So they have been selected at a very top high percentage level, right? So now the companies are reevaluating, they are planning that in the future, they have to make sure that the profit is there to the company, loss should not happen. So they are also evaluating that how many people are there on the bench. First, they will prioritize them and they will give the projects to them. If the layoff is also happening, so first, the people who are on the bench, those would be getting impacted, right? So see, even if the recession will be there, it will not result like what it happened in the 2008, in the year of 2008, right? But it would definitely impact. But again, you know, it's all a part of how do you upskill yourself? How do you make sure that you are well aware, well versed with the recent tools and technologies, right? Once this recession will get over, so there is no company, or you know, there are hardly any few people who's who are not dependent on softwares, who are not impacted, who are not dependent on technology, right? So technology, or you can say engineering department, are there. They will be getting less impacted by this recession, right? As organizations are already much more mature to handle these kind of impacts, and Indian IT industry is very strong. And for sure, you won't see that much kind of layoffs happening. But yes, the job market, you know, you can see the jobs have got decreased, the calls have got decreased. You're not getting that often that test assessment links. So that means there is some internal planning, there is some restructure kind of thing going on within the companies, because of which they are taking time. They want to evaluate where they stand, to what level they have to make a progress, to what moment they have to go for a jump. So that's how internal discussions and you know, this planning is going on. That is why you can see this kind of, you know, bit slow in IT industry related to the hirings, related to jobs, or you can see the hiring has got freezed, internal things are happening. So don't worry about all these things. Take this as an opportunity to learn, just to ensure that, you know, once the market is in demand, once the IT industry is in boom, you should not be lagging behind, right? So learn all the new skills, learn all the new tools and technologies, because you never know when this scenario is going to get ended, and you will ultimately be getting a call. You might get multiple interview calls also, right? So don't worry about all these recession as of now, right? Stay positive, stay motivated, and wish you all the best for your career. Thank you.